Hi children, welcome you all for the today's English class.
Children, today this is our day 9 session of.
Children, let's see the poem Macavity the Mystery Cat and about the author now T.S. Eliot. September 26, 1888, January 4, 1965. The poet is T.S. Eliot and his year September 26, 1888. January 4, 1965.
Reading and writing. So make use of this opportunity, children. So please follow the instruction. Write the lines as it is. We are following because Principal Ma'am instructed clearly that only 6 lines need to be written every day on our sessions. So while we are sending the teaching videos, along with that we will send the handwriting video also. Please follow, read and send your videos Ruby's English group and write and send it to your handwriting book photocopies through Teachmint. Please follow the instruction, children, and do as it is, children. Let's move on to the session now. Children, let's start the reading part. Your textbook Honeydew, chapter 1, poem The Ant and the Cricket. Children, look at the poem The Ant and the Cricket, poem 1, from page number 22 from our Honeydew book. Let's start today's reading part. Look at the warm-up session here. A fable is a story often with animals as characters that conveys a moral. I'll repeat, a fable is a story often with animals as characters that conveys a moral. This poem about an ant and a cricket contains an idea of far-reaching significance, which is as true of a four-legged cricket as of a two-legged one. Surely you have seen a cricket that has two legs. I'll repeat, children. A fable is a story often with animals as characters that conveys a moral. This poem about an ant and a cricket contains an idea of far-reaching significance, which is as true of a four-legged creature cricket as of a two-legged one. Surely you have seen a cricket that has two legs. Let's read the first stanza in this session, children. A silly young cricket accustomed, A-C-C-U-S-T-O-M-E-D, accustomed to sing. A silly young creature, cricket, accustomed to sing through the worm, through, T-H-R-O-U-G-H, through the worm. Sunny months of gay summer and spring. Though the warm sunny months of gay summer and spring began to complain when he found that at home. A silly young cricket accustomed to sing through the warm, C-H-R-O-U-G-H, through the warm sunny months of gay summer and spring began to complain when he found that at home. Look at the next line, children. His cupboards was empty and winter was come. Not a crumb to be found on the snow-covered ground. Not a flower could he see. Not a leaf on a tree. Oh, what will become, says the cricket, of me. I'll repeat, children. A silly young cricket accustomed to sing through the warm sunny months of gay summer and spring began to complain when he found that at home his cupboard was empty and winter was come. Not a crumb, C-H-C-R-U-M-B, crumb means small bit piece, to be found on the snow covered ground. Not a flower could he see. Not a leaf on the tree. Oh, what will become, says the cricket, of me.
So that's the end of the first stanza, children, from today's reading part. Complete reading and send your reading video in the group. Now let's move on to the writing part. Children, take your handwriting book and follow the instruction. Write the date first, children, then draw lines, and please follow the page, maintain the page. Please don't write extra lines. Only when we have a English teaching video, we have write handwriting session. In that session, how many lines I am writing, the same line should be written in your handwriting book. So this will be checked by ma'am when you submit your handwriting book. So please write along with me and don't write the extra pages and don't write ugly. It should be neat with proper pattern. So as it is given the dotted lines, your handwriting should be maintained. So please cooperate with us and do the needful. Let's move on to the today's writing part. Children, let's start our today's handwriting part. Take your handwriting book, all of you. Page number 6. Take your handwriting book. So till R we have completed, children. Now we have to start. Yes. So write today's date, children. 3/9/2021. Draw lines like this and write over the dotted line. So first you should start from the dotted line, children. So I am just writing over the dotted line slowly. Sharp your pencil and write. Write over the dotted line. Slowly you should write, children. Write slowly over the dotted line properly. So write neatly like this. So I have completed the dotted line now. So now I am starting the next line, children. Write slowly like this. So it should be written inside the blue line only. Sharp your pencil and write slowly like this. So that's all I have completed, S. Now I am going to start T. So look at the stroke here, how it should be written. Write over the dotted line properly. So it should be over the dotted line only, it should not be outside. So that's all, I have completed the dotted line. Now I am starting the next line, children. Write neatly and slowly like this. Follow the same pattern like this. So that's all. So today you need to write yes and T from page number 6. So write neatly, children, with date. Write the date. Draw lines in between the strokes. Then write over the dotted line first. Then next line you need to write. So that's all from the today's handwriting part, children. Send your
reading video in the group and send your handwriting through TeachMin in your sections.
So children, follow the instruction and do your work properly and send your assignments regularly.